We handle a variety of personal injury cases, predominantly automobile collisions, but any personal injury case where you're injured as a result of someone else's negligence or intentional act, that's something we would look at. I think the stereotypical injury attorney would be someone who is too busy for his clients or not accessible to his clients. That's just not the case in this office. The main thing that makes my firm different is the amount of access you have directly to me. I am the lead attorney in personal injury cases, and you can call me directly. You're gonna have my cell phone number as a client. You can text me, you can email me. I answer my own line. There's no gatekeeper with me, and a sort of a benefit of having a bit of a smaller firm. Personal injury cases are about being made whole. So the whole point of the case, if you're injured, is to undo the injury or treat it in the most medically reasonable way. And if compensation via money is what's required, and that's what happens too, generally both. People should hire me to be their injury attorney because I have a lot of experience doing injury law. I began practicing in 2011. And since that time, that's predominantly what I do. I have done a countless number of personal injury cases, automobile collisions, dog bites, premises liability, all kinds of things. Personal injury law is the only thing that I do. It's really what my expertise is in. The best thing you can do if you've been injured is to contact an attorney. Most injury cases are going to involve dealing with an insurance carrier on some level, not all, but most. Insurance companies, generally speaking, have their own interests in mind. That's the primary thing. They have legal obligations to their own insured. When you buy a policy of insurance, there's a contract in play and they have to live up to their end of it. That being said, if they can live up to their contract technically without spending any money, that's the whole point. So you need a lawyer that knows how to talk to insurance companies, that knows what you're entitled to get and is able to negotiate effectively with these people who are very practiced at denying claims and preventing you from getting everything you want to get. My goal for my clients is always to make them whole. At the end of the case, I want you to walk away as you were before the injury occurred, if that's possible. Some injuries are so severe that that's just not practical. But there are other ways to make you whole if you can't be made well again. There are a whole variety of injuries that could be associated with any particular personal injury case, you know, depending on what it is. If it's an automobile collision, you're probably going to see a lot of back injuries and neck injuries. These things can be chronic in nature. They can last years. Ongoing treatment is something that's pretty typical with those kinds of injuries, but there's a lot of other things you can get too. Dog bites can leave you scarred or disfigured. You know, a slip and fall in a bad situation could leave you with broken limbs. I mean, there is really no short answer to that question. Anything that can be injured, can be injured. So in personal injury law, not everyone has to engage in a full-blown lawsuit. Certainly that's a thing that happens quite regularly, but it's not every case. Some cases are effectively resolved without a lawsuit. If there's an insurance carrier that you're negotiating with, the outcome might be achievable without ever actually having to engage in a full-blown lawsuit. That's where having an experienced attorney comes into play. You need someone that knows how to negotiate, has a lot of experience. You know, hopefully you're able to get through it without having to go down that path. Who can be held liable in a personal injury case depends on a whole variety of factors. Certainly with regard to automobile collisions, the drivers can be held liable. Sometimes the owners can be held liable, the owners of the vehicle. Or if an injury occurs on a property, the property owner or the tenants can be liable. It depends on, you know, the fact pattern as it exists. The one thing I would stress about personal injury cases is the importance of hiring an attorney. There's so many people that try to engage this process without talking to a lawyer because they think it's going to be expensive or some kind of hassle or whatever the case may be. But if you don't talk to an attorney, the insurance companies will know you don't have an attorney. They know they can get away with things and you're just not very likely to get compensated in a way that makes sense. When you come to my office for an initial consultation, the first thing I'd say about that is it's free. You're going to come to my office and sit down directly with me, and we're going to talk about your case. We'll talk about your injuries. We're going to discuss what your goals are and what you would see as a good resolution to your situation.